Hi there, welcome back to the Scriptcase Macros course. This video is going to look at the SC field disabled record macro. So my name is Nate Carpenter, and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So let's go ahead and get started and see what this macro does. So this macro allows us to dynamically disable a field for forms with multiple records. So that's multiple records or some sort of editable grid form. We'll look at those. Here's the documentation for it. Pretty simple. Pass through the field name, true, false, and then any parameters there. Got a couple options for the parameters. So this is only multiple record form, editable grid, or editable grid view. So true or false, true is going to turn it on, and false is going to turn it off. This is just going to disable that field, and you can pass through multiple fields. And you can do it for I, insert, or U, update mode for that form, or do it a couple different ways. Here's an option where you just do it for all, including updating and inserting there. And then here's where you're turning it back on, so false. And then you can do it only for updating here with the U pass as a parameter there. And then here's some more with multiple fields and some different settings here with an if. We're going to do something kind of like that. So let's go over here to our Scriptcase development environment. And I've got a pretty simple form set up here. So form actor disabled records, so pretty basic form, and it's in an editable grid form. So we can edit multiple records at a time. Let me go ahead and run this so you can see it. We're going to disable one of the fields on this form here. So as you can see, I have all these records here, and we're going to disable this first name field. So we're going to disable it first on update mode. So to do that, we need to go to events and then onload record. So not the onload. The onload is when it loads all the records, but onload record is going to run it for each individual record here. And we're going to pass through that field name. So first underscore name is the name of that field there. So pass that through. And then we're going to do this only on update mode. So when we insert, we still can update the first name, but then first name is not editable at all. So that's how we're doing that. So let's go ahead and run that. And now we shouldn't be able to edit the first name field. Wait for it to load here. And there we go. As you can see, the first name field is grayed out, so you can view the data. And if I click add new, I can go ahead down there at the bottom. You can see it added a row, and I can edit that first name. I can add a first name in there, and then once I save it, I'm not able to. Now let's change this a little bit. Let's make a conditional. So let's make the first name disabled if the first name equals ed. So this is kind of an arbitrary case, but you can see how you might use this depending on what you want to do with your data, what conditions you want to put on it for being able to edit it. So the first name is going to equal Ed. So let me go ahead and copy that option right there, E and D, all capitalized. Put that in quotes. So when first name exactly equals Ed, we're going to go ahead and disable that record right like so. So let's go ahead and run that now. And all the others should be editable except the row with first name of Ed. So wait for it to load here. It's coming around here. And there we go. As you can see, all the records are editable in the first name field, except that one with the first name of Ed. So that's how you use SC field disabled record to disable record fields on a multiple record form.